Good evening. Welcome to Chiller Night Theater. I am your host, the legendary Spirit of Halloween and Ghoul Galore, Jack Shadow. Have you ever wondered what you would do if you ran into a prehistoric caveman? Have you ever wondered, would he be friendly? Would he be savage? Would he be friend or foe? Have you ever thought about this? No, not even a little. Seriously, not once. Really, who doesn't think about this kind of stuff? What do you mean? Well, tonight, we'll get you thinking about it as we meet a caveman named Iga. Iga's a savage brute, a 7-foot-tall caveman from prehistoric times that is somehow alive and well in California in the year 1962. Look, let's try not to think too much into this one and just enjoy, shall we? Okay. Turn those lights down low. Pull that woolly mammoth rug up around you tight and settle in as we watch Curse of the Caveman. No, I'm just kidding. It's called Iga. Yep, let's watch Iga.
Hi, Roxy. What are you doing in town? Thought I was supposed to meet you up at the club. Well, you still are. I just bought myself a new swimming suit tonight.
Oh?
Yes. See?
That? Well, I get off work in 10 minutes.
Follow me out then.
Follow you? Listen, I can change clothes and beat you out there. That's my girl. Her father's Robert I. Miller. Writes all those adventure books. You ought to see her swim.
Hey! Gee, I sure am sorry, sir. I guess I was thinking about having dinner with my girl. She lives up at the club.
It's me, Tom.
Oh, Tommy. Oh.
What's the matter? What happened?
Is he gone?
Who?
Is he?
I don't see anybody. Just take it easy and tell me what happened.
I saw a giant.
What?
Well, I see it. Honest, I saw a giant.
He doesn't believe me.
You didn't really expect anyone to, did you, Miss Millett?
Why not? It's the truth.
Honey, a prehistoric monster is a rather large order to swallow.
Dad, I didn't say he was a monster. He was a giant. Well, you know, a caveman.
Club and all, eh?
Yes.
What my daughter saw, she saw. Now, let's just let it go at that.
Okay. But if you see her giant again, let me know in time to take some pictures.
She will.
Dad, you don't believe me either.
Roxy, of course I believe you. I believe you saw something.
Well, I saw a giant. A prehistoric giant.
How about it, Tom? What'd you see?
Like I told you, Mr. Miller, I wasn't there until afterwards.
Tommy Nelson. I know what I saw.
Sure, Roxy, but I mean giants.
There were giants. The Bible says so.
Yes, it does, in the book of Genesis. Something about in those days, giants walked the earth.
Well, then.
Maybe we can get some flashlights and go out and take a look for ourselves. Huh?
No, this thing can wait until morning. Now, you kids go and take your swim before the pool closes.
In the morning now.
It's a promise.
Dad still doesn't believe me.
Sure he does.
And neither do you.
I swear on my Elvis Presley LP. How big did you say he was?
Oh, bigger than anybody you ever saw.
I bet you were scared, huh?
A little. But I had the funniest feeling he wouldn't hurt me.
Yeah?
In fact, I thought it was kind of cute.
Oh.
Realistic about this. You said yourself that you fainted. Isn't it possible that you dreamed this whole idea?
No, Dad, I didn't. There was a giant.
Now, I don't want to call this story of yours a lot of foolishness, and I haven't so far, have I?
No.
But if there were a giant, if anyone at all
had been
here... Mr. Miller,
come here.
What'd you find?
I don't know. It sure looks like a footprint, though.
Well, let me see. There's the heel, and there's the toe.
Look at the size of that. It must have been made by...
Say it.
A giant.
What did I tell you? And that's for finding it.
I'll find the big boy himself for it if you feel like that.
He left the road right here. Watch out for snakes.
Oh!
Better go back to Bob.
No! He's my giant.
Holy cow, he was standing right here watching us. And then he turned and took off her.
Shadow Mountain. Do you suppose that's where he lives?
It's possible. That would account for his never having been seen before.
It's too bad we didn't bring the doom buggy. We'd go after him.
What for?
I had to get some pictures. Maybe even to bring him back. A lot of people aren't going to believe this giant jazz.
No, we're not sending about this, you understand?
Why not? After the way everyone laughed at me.
Your turn will come. I'm going up on Shadow Mountain with a camera.
Are you going to write a book about the giant, Mr. Miller?
That's the idea, Tom.
I'll take you up there. My doom buggy's all ready to go.
No, thanks.
It is. I just gave it the works.
There's no offense, son. But I'd like to take this trip in something a little bit safer. Now, my credit cards are in the desk drawer. You make sure you leave them there.
This thing's supposed to be safer than my dune buggy?
All right, Kruger, let's go. Thank you.
Now, don't you forget. I want you to meet me at the mouth of Deep Canyon tomorrow at 4.
understand. That's just one of those things. Just a minute, please. Do you know where Deep Canyon is?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. I've been there lots of times. Why?
Don't worry, Mr. Kruger. I'll take care of it. Yes. Thanks for calling. Goodbye.
What's up?
That was Mr. Kruger from the airport. The helicopter blew a gasket or something. He won't be able to pick Dad up.
At Deep Canyon?
Yes.
No problem. We'll get the dune buggy and we'll whiz right out there.
This is whizzing?
Wait till we get off the highway.
You're watching EGA. Sorry about that. But hey, this movie does have some redeeming qualities to it. Did you know that the movie is actually scientifically accurate? Science consultant Roy Packard was hired by the producers to ensure the accuracy of how a caveman from the Paleolithic era would live and what his cave dwelling would most likely be like. You know, with the decapitated heads decorating the parlor and the hot spring well in the kitchen. That was actually very common back then.
Jack.
I'm sorry. I made that up. That's not true. None of that's true. I just kind of wanted you to like it. Aha! I just thought of something. The caveman in tonight's movie is played by Richard Kiel. Now, some of you may recognize him as a villain known as Jaws in the Roger Moore James Bond films. Richard studied acting at the prestigious Royal Scottish Academy of Music and Drama, which is ranked as one of the best acting schools in the world. Now, this certainly helped Richard land the part of Iga, as he was up against some of the best and most competitive actors of the time.
Jack.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. None of that is true. Sorry. He got the part because he was 7 feet 2 inches tall. Actually, Archul Sr., the writer and director of tonight's film, came up with the idea for the movie after meeting Richard, who was working as a bouncer at a cowboy bar at the time. That's literally how it happened. That's it. Not too much thought was put into it. Now don't you put too much thought into it either. Just sit back, relax, don't turn that channel, and let's get back to Iga. What do you say? No? No? Hey, come on. I'm not going back in here alone. No. Put that remote down. Hey. Don't make me come out there. All right, that's better. Let's get back to the movie.
Hey, take it easy on that water.
Well, I don't want it to dry out before Dad gets here. And don't you eat anymore.
Okay.
It's 9 o'clock. What do you suppose happened?
Nothing happened. He's not coming on a bus, you know. You can't expect him to be right on the dot.
I know, but he should have made it before dark.
Don't worry about it. He'll see the campfire and come walking in on us any minute now.
That's what you said 2 hours ago.
Well, he will.
Well, if you believe that, what's the idea of the bedrolls?
Look, I carry all this junk in the buggy anyway, so you might as well get some use out of it.
I'm not sleepy.
So, just lie down, take a rest for a while. I'll keep the fire going.
Hey, what are you doing with that?
I always carry a gun in the desert. There's coyotes around a camp.
Put it away. We're not playing cowboy.
You know, there's mountain lions around here, too.
Well, they won't come near a fire, I know that much. And I'm not gonna have you take a shot if something turns out to be dead.
Okay. I'll put it away in one condition, that you crawl in and get some rest.
Okay.
Wouldn't you like to know?
you suppose Dad found the giant? Or the giant found him?
Nah. Giant probably is way up in the mountain. Your dad wasn't going that far.
I guess not.
Oh, it's my transistor. Something's wrong with it.
No kidding.
Yeah, sometimes a bump starts it off and you gotta hit it again to stop it. Oh, I must have bumped it again.
You must have. Hey, have you been at this? We were saving for Dad.
What?
The stew.
I didn't touch it.
Well, I sure didn't. And look at...
Listen, if he comes back for that club, we'd want to be anywhere around here. Sure it is?
Well, I borrowed it enough. Look at where it's smashed.
Well, he could have dropped it.
Well, then why didn't he pick it up?
Well, it's broken. It's no good to him.
Oh, well, it's also insured. Let's not kid ourselves.
Let's not jump to conclusions either. Come on, let's try the next ravine.
I don't know.
Well, I'll climb up there ways and see if the buggy can get through. No, you better stay here.
No.
There's no use in both of us going. We gotta come back for the buggy anyway.
Well, then we'll come back. I'm not going to sit here doing nothing.
Oh, women. Look, you stay here with the buggy.
Nope.
And drive it up to meet me when I give you the signal. That'll save us both a trip. Come on.
Well, okay.
the gun. Toss it. Give me a blast in that horn if you see anything.
Don't worry about that.
Roxy. Roxy. Roxy.
Oh, Dad.
Oh.
Oh, are you hurt?
I think my collarbone's broken.
Here, let me help you.
How did you get here?
Well, we came looking for you, and we were both so worried that we didn't know what to do.
No, no. No. No, no. No, no. She is mine. She's mine.
He understands you.
Oh, we've got a beautiful friendship going. Take it easy.
Me scare him?
Smile. He likes your perfume.
Smell all you want. Go ahead.
What became of the others? Keep smiling. You didn't come out here alone, did you?
No. Tom's with me. I mean, he's out there someplace.
Hold still. He's just curious. Hold still.
It's real, see?
Looking.
What's he doing?
Looking for lice, I believe.
Oh, really?
Careful, honey. Take it easy. He won't hurt you.
He hurt you?
No. I did that myself when I fell on the camera.
Dad, I think you better break this up before I scream.
Tell him you're hungry.
I'm not.
Well, think of the alternative.
I'm hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Hungry.
Some time.
Yiga Chow Chowd Quagalumba. Sichra. Sichra.
Come on, Dan. Let's make a run for it.
Yeah, it won't work. The entrance is blocked.
Oh, what are we gonna do?
I don't know. But we'll think of something. He's telling his family all about you. He told them about me last night.
Think how lonely he must be.
I know whatever he is, he's a human being. Shake hands with him, Roxy.
Oh, Dad. Oh, please meet you. Doesn't he know they're dead?
I think so. He just can't make himself accept it.
Well, I'm not having any trouble. And how are you feeling today? Oh, that's fine.
Can't eat any more of this.
Fake it.
That's what I've been doing. Now I'm getting
sick.
Iga.
Is that his name?
It might be. That's the word he says most of the time. Iga.
Oh, Dad, no. That's all I need now is a good drink of health. Ooh, I don't see how anybody could drink that world of stuff. I guess it can't hurt me.
Make it last as long as you can. He won't hurt you if you're doing something.
A prehistoric gentleman, huh? Thank you. Well, here's to you. This water doesn't make you strong. You have to be strong to drink in the first place. No, I'm still thirsty. Thank you. That doesn't.
What is it?
Believe it or not, Dad, I'm going to look at this etching. Oh, this is nice. No. This.
Nice.
Let's see what you mean.
What is it?
Look at this drawing. It's me in my car. This one. It's me.
Roxy!
If Ego makes me drink any more of this sulfur water, I'll die.
We've got to keep him busy.
I know.
And it's not so bad, as a matter of fact. A little bitter. But it seems to have a certain quality that's good for you. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if the sulfur in these walls isn't what's kept these giants alive all these years.
You mean these giants have always been here?
Where have you seen those before?
In that cave in France.
Exactly.
Sure.
Same style, same everything. Definitely prehistoric. Yes, I'd say that he and his tribe have always been here.
Are there others?
No, he's the last one.
How can you be sure?
I took a good look at his family. From the condition of the shrouds, I'd say the last one died 50, 100 years ago.
How old does that make him?
Oh, I wouldn't know, guess.
Walter, there you are. Stop soaking. I mean, I wasn't teasing you earlier. If you want to go picking up women in the cemetery, then by all means do it. Hold on, I've got to adjust my hat. What? What? Oh, no, I wasn't calling you loser. No. For the love of... Look, I'm not judging you. This is a safe place for creatures like yourself who just happen to not date a whole lot or hang out with women or even know how to get a date. I mean, it's a good thing you're dead because you couldn't get a woman if your life depended on it. I mean, not even a little. You're one of the most socially impaired zombies I know. But that's not to say that, you know... Oh, get back here. Don't be such a little ghoul. It's like walking on eggshells with some of these guys around here. I suppose I better brush up on my sensitivity skills. Chummy with her own self before waking up. Does anybody know what that was all about? I mean, seriously, what's up with that? And things are getting creepy with Captain Labesh as his room gets infested with snakes. Or does it? They're there, then they're not. They're there, then gone. There, then gone. Sort of like my attention span with this movie so far, to be honest. It was there for a brief moment, and then the next instant it disappears. Much like a woman's interest with our zombie Walter. Ah! Oh, good Lord, I didn't see you there, Walter. I'm sorry, old boy. Oh, get back here. Oh, don't be like that. Stop crying. You're getting all wet. 120 years old, and he's still got a dead wedding problem. Oh, they didn't hear me. Oh, come on. Who's a good zombie? Who's a good zombie? Come on, Walter. Okay, let's get on with things.
So what have we learned from the last segment of the movie? No, seriously, I'm asking you, because I have no idea what we just saw. I think Annabelle has some serious issues. No, seriously. I think she's a bit of a narcissist. Wow, and talk about self-love? Some strange things are going on, and not just in Annabelle's room, but in Captain Labesh's room as well. How creepy would it be to have snakes in your bed? Ooh, can you imagine, like, laying in bed at night after the movie when you're drifting off to sleep? Whatever you do, don't think of snakes in your bed. In your bed. Snakes in your bed. Don't do it. Don't dream or think snakes in your bed. Snakes in your bed. Now with snakes remotely out of your mind, now and later, let's get back to snake people.
Roxy.
Oh, it's you, Dad.
Go see if the rock's in place.
He's gone. Now's our chance.
It's there. What are we going to do? What can I do?
Help me back. I gotta sit down. No. Don't touch it.
It's got to be tied up or something, doesn't it?
There's some aspirin in my ear bag.
I don't see it.
He brought it here. It must be around someplace. Keep looking. You probably hid it somewhere.
Oh, here it is.
The aspirin's in that small pocket. Give me a two.
Drink a lot of water. It'll give you strength.
It won't knit bones, honey.
It's got to be tied up with something, doesn't it?
Oh, it feels pretty good now.
Liar.
That's no way to talk to your father.
The trouble with you is it spoiled you.
You sure did.
What can I do?
Nothing. I'll just sit here.
How about if I washed your face? Or gave you a shave? It'll make you feel better. You've got all your junk here.
Okay. The entrance. I'll get his attention. You run
and
out.
And leave you?
Do as I tell you.
Not this time, Dad.
You were lucky last night. He's had time to think about you.
I'm not going to leave you to get your head bashed in. My father didn't raise me that way.
Something else. Make a production out of it. Tape. Hum. Whistle. Come on. Brandon, keep busy. Here he comes.
Much for my sex appeal. You're running out of whiskers. Now I suppose he wants a shave.
Good. Give it to him.
Anything to please a customer.
Try these. Better watch him with that shaving balm. Did a better job of shaving him, Roxy.
Hey.
There's no way of telling how old that fellow
Look.
Is.
Don't get the idea I don't like you, but my father...
save yourself.
I'll keep you so busy, he'll forget the rock.
Once you're outside, run.
Come on.
Outside.
She-chaw. She-chaw.
Everything's all right.
Dad!
He's okay. He's waiting for us.
Thank you.
kid.
Dad!
Run, kids, run!
Okay?
Honey?
Just fine, Dad.
Wow, wait, there he is. So long, High Pockets.
Thank you.
Uh-oh. Yiga's leaving the cave in pursuit of Roxy. Pretty intense, eh, folks? No? Not really, you say? Look, when you do a program like this, you're gonna have your good B-rated horror films like The Last Man on Earth, Horror Express, House on Haunted Hill, and The Crawling Eye. And then you'll also have Yiga. Tonight's movie was American-made, filmed, like a lot of these, in Bronson Canyon, California. Now, you might wonder, if it was filmed in English with American actors, why does it look like it was dubbed? Well, after filming the entire movie in 14 days on a budget of $15,000, it was discovered that the sound recorders had actually screwed up and didn't film most of the movie with sound. The bulk of the film had to be dubbed in later during post-production. Now, R. Charles Sr., the guy who made the movie, wasn't really out to make a blockbuster epic, which is painfully obvious. He made the movie as a way to get his son, R. Charles Jr., noticed. Now, Jr. is the young man playing Tom Nelson, Roxy's singing boyfriend. Now, I will give credit where credit is due, though. Yiga opened at a drive-in in Omaha, Nebraska, and made $15,000 in one night, which is what it cost to actually make the movie. R. Charles made $1 million from Yiga, so good for him. Not bad, not bad at all. Which is not how I can describe this movie. Okay, folks, we're almost there. Let's dig in. We can do this. Wake up those around you and let's get ready to watch the conclusion to Yiga. Hey, wake up.
Drunk. Give me the keys to the car. Now, baby, I just had one. That's all. Just one, baby. That's all. I've just had one.
One bottle?
Hey, baby.
You've had enough.
Well, I'll tell you when I've had enough. You do me a great injustice. I've had enough. Mm-hmm.
That happens to be one of my favorite ties.
But the color.
You gave it to me 4 years ago.
Oh. Why, it's lovely. Are you sure you're feeling well enough to go out tonight?
Honey, we've got to go out.
Well, it's not anything special. It's just a party.
Your whole gang will be there.
Yeah.
You can't avoid them forever.
No.
Some of them laugh a little.
Well, if I know Agnes Henderson, she'll laugh a lot. What'll happen to him?
I don't know, but I'm certain we're doing the right thing. If we were to reveal that a giant actually exists, there'd be a whole army out there tracking him down like an animal.
No, they wouldn't. We wouldn't let them.
Honey, he's from another age, another eon. Come in.
Hello, Mr. Miller.
Hello, Tom.
Wow, Dee, wow, wow.
You sure look swell, Roxy.
Thank you. I'll only be a minute.
Is something wrong, Mr. Miller?
We're just talking about our little adventure.
Oh, I see.
You do?
Well, sure. A girl like Roxy don't get over a thing like that right away.
Doesn't.
That's what I say. She's got to get her mind off it. And this hop tonight will help.
Hop?
Yeah, my combo's going to be there. And they swing.
So I understand.
I'm ready.
Well, let's split then. Mr. Miller, I got my dad's wheels tonight.
Really? Do they fit on your car?
You're funny, Mr. Miller. Real funny.
Grr.
Mm-hmm.
Possible from that music. It's a good idea, but we guess here.
No, the music's wonderful. I could listen to Tom sing by the hour.
And you have.
I just wanted some fresh air, that's all.
Is it, honey?
No. Dad, I've got the funniest feeling.
What is it?
I can't describe it. But I just know something's happened to him.
Him?
Iga. The giant. Or whatever he is. Something's happened to him.
Roxy, look at me. I love you very much. You're more like your mother every day. Every living thing was her personal concern, and she worried about them.
That's just it, Dad. But you see, worry isn't the feeling that I have. I don't know what it is. He's a creature. Well, you just have to look at him to see that. He even tried to kill us. But...
You can't get him out of your mind. Somebody else. Maybe him, huh?
Hey! Where you been? I was belting out a tune just for you in there. I look up and you're gone.
We could hear every word, Tom. I said hear, not understand.
You're funny, Mr. Miller. Really funny. Come on, Roxy, let's dance.
Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
I thought I heard sirens.
That's Dino's sax. It leaks.
Is he real?
Who is he?
Yes, he was real. It says so in the book of Genesis. There were giants in the earth in those days. Chapter 4, verse 32.
Now, you know when you tune into Chiller Night Theater, some nights you're going to get a really great horror or sci-fi movie. And then other nights, you're going to get EGOT. But hey, we made it through, and right now that's all that matters. Thanks for bearing through this with me, for joining me tonight. Let's meet again next week as I feature yet another classic, or not-so-classic, Chiller feature. I wasn't kidding about that not-so-classic part. Anyway, have a frightening night, and I'll see you next week. Until then, I bid you adieu, my children of the night.
Just because something isn't good doesn't mean it's bad.